Dear students, that notification has been released and I hope you have gone through it. One of the things which is missing in the ZAC notification and which typically is explained closer to the exam is what is the structure of paper. All they have mentioned is there will be four sections like last year, which is quantitative aptitude, decision making and verbal reasoning. The fourth section they have mentioned is GK. Now till the year before last, there used to be an essay section which was discontinued last year and I don't expect it to come back. So from your point of view, from a preparation perspective, please remember the structure of last year is most likely to be followed. In fact, there's a pattern. If you look at the last 4-5 years papers, progressively the level of difficulty of maths was decreasing. The number of questions were coming down so that students get more time to solve the paper and are not in a rush. And over the last couple of years, the number of questions has stabilized to around 75 to 80 questions. And that is what should happen this year too. So very quickly, the last year paper, the quant section had, if I just confirm, 27 questions in quant, 21 questions in decision making, and 26 questions of verbal reasoning. This was 165 minutes, and 15 minutes given separately only for GK, which had 25 questions. So expect the same structure to continue. Now the important thing about this paper is, unlike CAT, which is a maths oriented paper, XLRI or ZAT is an English oriented paper. The verbal reasoning or the verbal logic section is more difficult than that in CAT or than that of CAT. CAT is essentially reading comprehension. You will have all kind of verbal reasoning and the level of difficulty will be higher. But unlike CAT, speed is not an issue. Understanding is an issue. Secondly, decision making is almost like reading comprehension. Thirdly, quant, 27 questions have been the number of questions in the last couple of years, but the level of difficulty is easy at best medium and easier than CAT, and it gives you and you have more time to do the questions. So if you are good in English, this is the paper you should definitely be going for. In terms of cutoffs, the interesting bit about ZAT is if you get a double digit score in all three sections, you are safe, which means a score of about 10 in English, a 10 in decision making and about 10 in maths will typically mean you have cleared the sectional cutoffs. An overall score of about 35 would be required to get an interview call for XLRI BM program. The interview call of for the HRM would be at about 32 to 33 marks. Now if you have a female candidate, the number required for you will be about one mark less than what I just said, which means girls, the cutoff for the BM is likely to be about 34 marks and about 32 marks for HRM. GK, yeah, just prepare for GK as you would prepare for other papers. Don't worry too much about it. GK is not taken into account for interview calls. In the interview, they might ask you about GK, but by and large, it is not an important issue. There have been cases of students who have not done well in GK still getting through to XLRI. Finally, please don't forget to apply for the NCR campus. It's a new campus, so the cutoff is likely to be lower. But since it is XLRI, it is going to be, I would say, it should be preferred over many of the Tier 2 and Tier 3 institutes. XLRI, please fill up the form. Don't wait for the last date, but if you delay it too much, you may miss the deadline or you may end up paying extra to apply. Remember, ZAT application has to be followed by separately ticking the boxes for XLRI program. So there's a ZAT fee and there's an XLRI fee. And when you're paying the XLRI fee, please tick all the program, which is BM, HRM in Jamshedpur as well as in the NCR campus. We'll come back again with more details about the paper and the way to handle the paper in a few days.
Career Launcher. Make your parents explode with joy.